This is how a man survived alone at sea for 438 days. A miraculous story. Today we have a very strange story. The story of the man who lived and survived at sea for 438 days, which is currently the record for the longest time a person has survived while lost at sea. Let's know the strange story of this man and the difficulties he had to face. First, we must know a thing or two about the Pacific Ocean. It's the largest ocean on the surface of the globe, which amounts to almost a third of it. Therefore, if we collect all the land on the planet and put it beside the Pacific Ocean, we'll see that the Pacific Ocean is bigger than it. The Pacific Ocean is completely empty except for a few small islands scattered everywhere. The probability that someone will survive in it is very small and almost impossible. And this is what made this story so amazing and weird at the same time. It's the story of a man named José Salvador Alvarenga from the Republic of Salvador, located in Central America. He's currently the record holder for the longest time a person has spent while at sea. In fact, this is a number that no one wants to break, and it was definitely not his desire to break it. The things that happened to him during his journey will leave you speechless and clueless about how this man could survive all that time. Currently, the record that Alvarenga managed to reach is 438 days, and most likely no one can break it anytime soon, because the probability of a person dying before breaking it is much higher. The journey from which all this tragedy began was supposed to last only 2 days. Alvarenga was a professional fisherman and would normally have his close friend accompany him. But this time his friend wasn't available, so Alvarenga had to search for another one, a 23-year-old young man named Ezequiel Cordoba, who agreed to go with him. The voyage took off on November 17, 2012, from the small town known as Costa Azul, located on the Mexican Pacific coast. The plan was to sail for 30 hours, so they used a small fishing boat that was definitely not equipped for the nightmare they were about to face, neither in terms of space nor provisions. The boat was about 7 meters long and had no roof or cabin, but only a small engine. All they had was fishing gear and a container to put the fish they caught in. They also had news that there was a storm coming in their area. However, it seemed that their condition at the time was not good, which forced them to go and earn a living. Accordingly, they decided to take the chance and sail more than 120 kilometers from the coast, which is the perfect area for fishing. At 1 o'clock in the morning, the storm had arrived, and their boat was likely to sink. Because of the fear they had the difficulty they faced in dealing with the storm, they had to throw most of the tools and things, which were worth thousands of dollars. They even threw the fish they caught during this period in the sea to lighten the weight of the boat and be able to move easily and more flexibly. They were about 6 hours away from the coast, so they traveled through the storm at night in a desperate attempt to return to the coast. At 7 in the morning, they were only 24 kilometers from the coast and could even see the mountains in the horizon. Unfortunately, the engine of the boat suddenly stopped, and they had no other means of movement. No oars, no sails, or anything else. The wind and the storm began to sweep them towards the ocean slowly and without having any means of resistance. Fortunately, they had a radio that they used to communicate with their manager because they were close to the coast. They informed him of the situation, and their manager replied that he'll come soon along with the Coast Guard. Unfortunately, during their communication process, the battery of the radio expired. Suddenly, their last hope disappeared. Just imagine if you were in their place, lost the last means of communication, became completely isolated in the sea, and the wind pulled you away from the place you told them you were at. In addition, the land and mountains that you were seeing begin to disappear bit by bit. I don't think anyone can imagine how desperate and frustrated they were at this moment. Their manager acted quickly and actually went out to search for them with another group of fishermen. He even told the authorities to search for them using their boats and planes. They searched for them for several days. Unfortunately, the wind swept their boat way too far, and in just 5 days they were 450 kilometers away from the coast. There was nothing other than the ocean in all directions. Their boat was so small that it was almost impossible for people to see them from the sky if a plane or a helicopter passed over them. They had no way to ask for help, not a pointing gun, not even a distinct colored piece of fabric. They had no way to signal to people but their hands, so they knew there was very little chance of them surviving. Despite this, And despite their broken psyche and spirits, the survival instinct made them adapt to the situation anyway. Concerning food, they had to catch fish and birds that hovered around the boat with their bare hands and eat them raw. Also, they were able to collect some plastic bottles they found in the sea and use them to collect rainwater. There were long periods of time without rain, so they were forced to drink the blood of turtles they caught. They even drank their urine sometimes. Although drinking urine is not helpful in any form, it's very harmful, but in such circumstances, a person doesn't know what to do. I think it's possible that anyone would act the same if they reached the state and lived in the same experience. Imagine that time passes by, day after day, month after month. You're in a 7-meter boat and have only one person to talk to. All you can do to entertain yourself is fishing. It's natural for a person to go crazy in such circumstances. According to Alvarenga's story, his friend Cordoba, the young man who accompanied him, began to really lose his mind after only 4 months, and his psyche had deteriorated so much that he even thought of suicide. And with days, his body weakened more and more, and he became very ill due to the raw food they ate, to the point that he completely stopped eating. His body continued to weaken, and his illness increased until he died. Only 4 months passed, and Alvarenga lost the only person he had. He became lonely and still had a long way to go. However, his problem was no longer food and survival only, but things got worse and the situation became psychologically tiring. Thus, he no longer had anything to comfort him but himself. Imagine yourself in his place, alone in the middle of the ocean, surrounded by water from all directions. I don't know what the guy did to keep his sanity for that long. Alvarenga was almost in the middle of the Pacific Ocean at that time, and this place is considered one of the deadliest places in the world. Ships rarely pass in such areas, yet according to Alvarenga's story, a cargo ship passed by him when he was alone. He kept shouting and waving at them, and 4 people actually saw him and waved back. Unluckily, the ship continued to sail, and they didn't stop or give him any attention at all. Just imagine his psyche at that moment. After he was lost for months, he suddenly sees a ship and feels hope that the opportunity to escape from his hell has come, and in an instant, all his hope disappears. Alvarenga says he seriously thought of killing himself twice during the time he was lost. He says, "I raised the knife to my throat, and I had completely decided to slaughter myself, but I was very afraid of death and the pain that I would suffer from." So far, 11 months have passed, and Alvarenga has already sailed 8,000 kilometers on the small boat. His clothes were broken, and he had only a piece of cloth to protect himself from the sun rays. He was still alone, lost in the vast ocean. He remained in this condition for several more months, until almost 14 months had passed since the day he was lost. On January 30th, 2014, Alvarenga noticed fish pellets floating on the surface of the sea, and the number of birds increasing in the area. So he knew that there was an island or land nearby. About half a day passed, and he could see the island clearly. He really decided to abandon his boat and swim ashore. Alvarenga thought that the island was not inhabited in the beginning, but he luckily found a house and sought help from the people living there. Finally, he was able to communicate with the first human being after 430 days of his departure from his village and traveling about 11,000 kilometers. The name of the island to which Alvarenga was rescued is Ipon Atoll, and if he was not lucky enough to reach this island, he probably would never see land except in the Philippines, which is still 5,000 kilometers away from this island. It would have taken more than 240 extra days to reach it. After news spread that he'd been found, the authorities came and brought him back by plane after he recovered. After this nightmare is gone, Alvarenga decided to write a book telling about his experience and the events he went through. However, the family of the young man who went with him on the boat and lost his life decided to sue him and accuse him of killing the boy in order to eat him. By the way, this is not a very remote possibility because there are stories of people who get lost and have to eat people they're with to save themselves. The psychological and physical state that people experience in these situations causes them to do such cruel things. Indeed, this is a possibility, and he would certainly deny something like this if he really did eat the boy. However, I don't think anyone will know the truth for sure.